Energy, the capacity of a physical system to perform work. Here, the sun's light energy is being fixed by primary producers as they manufacture glucose in photosynthesis. This energy powers life on Earth, but it dissipates and it cannot be created nor destroyed. These laws of thermodynamics apply also to man-made systems, like this electricity power line, taking power from the grid to the farm. In today's lesson, we outline the range of energy sources available to society. We evaluate the advantages and disadvantages of two contrasting energy sources, and we discuss the factors that affect choice of energy sources adopted by different societies. Human society uses energy for two main purposes: industrial applications and domestic use. This energy demand is met by three major sources: the electric grid, fuel for transportation systems, and some other less significant sources. A simple power generating principle. A copper coil turns within a giant magnet. As this turbine rotates, an electrical current is generated. The key to generating this power is to find some source that's strong enough to rotate the turbines. The power of moving water is an excellent source of such energy. Hydropower can be generated by damming rivers, and through controlled release of the water, huge power generating turbines are rotated and millions of megawatts of power result. Tidal barrages use a similar principle with the ebb and flow of the tide. And wave power is yet another source of energy. But most of the energy consumed in human society still comes from non-renewable sources, sources which in time will be exhausted. One such source is nuclear energy. Through controlled nuclear reactions, energy can be released in massive amounts to convert water into steam. The steam, when channeled under high pressure, is sufficiently powerful to rotate giant turbines and generate electricity. The fossil fuels, coal, oil, and natural gas, are used in a similar way to generate electricity. One source of energy that we often take for granted is the direct rays of the sun. Solar energy is certainly a renewable source of energy. For once there is life on Earth, there will be energy from the sun. This home uses photovoltaic cells to convert light energy directly into electrical energy. Whereas here, at this solar furnace, the heat of the sun is being channeled to convert water into steam and to generate electricity. In some unique areas of the planet, like Iceland, there is an abundance of natural hot water from the earth, an excellent renewable source of energy. Geothermal energy, energy from burning biomass, is also considered as renewable, for it can be regenerated within a reasonable time period. A more recent application of biomass energy is the production of ethanol from corn in the United States to use as a fuel additive. A similar and even more extensive program is in use in Brazil, where sugarcane is the source of bioethanol. Most countries use a range of renewable and non-renewable sources of energy, but Brazil and France stand out, for in Brazil, 3/4 of the energy that comes from the grid is from the hydroelectric power of its giant network of dams. And in France, almost 80% of the power from its electricity grid comes from the non-renewable nuclear energy. In Brazil, there is a high demand for energy to fuel its rapidly growing economy, and full use is made of its large and powerful rivers to generate what for it is a cheap source of energy, for Brazil does not possess any large deposits of non-renewable sources of energy like coal, oil, and natural gas. In addition, use of hydropower lowers the carbon footprint and helps in meeting international commitments. The country has developed a lot of expertise with its large network of dams, and of course, there is no end in sight for this renewable source of energy. France, on the other hand, produces a lot of nuclear energy, excellent for maintaining the clean air, which is in high demand by its population. It helps the country to meet international agreements like the Kyoto Protocol, which limits carbon emissions. It has obvious health benefits and wide public acceptance. And France has a long history of using nuclear energy, and as such, it has developed a lot of expertise in this area. Hydropower, which is a renewable resource, does not come without its disadvantages. While Brazil makes good use of its advantages, some disadvantages include the effect on natural ecosystems, as the damming of rivers affects both aquatic and terrestrial environments. Millions of people are displaced when dams are created. There is need for a high initial investment to construct a mega dam. And there are many environmental impacts during the construction of these huge structures. Added to all of that, there is the looming danger of a catastrophic event like an earthquake triggering a flood. Nuclear power, though non-renewable, is an attractive option, for it only takes 1 kilogram of uranium to produce the equivalent amount of energy of 1,500 tons of coal. Some disadvantages of nuclear power include the need for expertise, the disposal of the radioactive spent nuclear reactor parts, the high initial investment required to set up such a plant, and of course the danger in case of a catastrophic event like an earthquake, as experienced very recently in Japan. But some important advantages that come from the use of nuclear power include the large amounts of energy that can be generated from very small amounts of uranium, the fact that there are no carbon dioxide emissions from nuclear power plants, which would help in meeting international commitments like the Kyoto Protocol.